motto at BKM Fitness Boot Camp has taken on new meaning in recent months.
And residents will drive by and they'll blow at it saying, yeah, 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 we will survive, we will survive.
All over Ferguson, Missouri, signs of healing, but also evidence that the fires of November still smolder. Lingering anger over a grand jury's decision not to charge a white police officer in the shooting death of 18-year-old Michael Brown boiled over during a recent meeting of the Governor's Ferguson Commission.
We're not going to keep standing for this. We're going to stand up for our race.
Stick together.
We're going to stand up for us white in America.
Activists held a mock tribunal for former officer Darren Wilson, who shot the unarmed Brown.
Now we can talk all day, but Michael Brown ain't coming back. So we talk about it and mourn about it, but what are we gonna do about it?
Ferguson officials are working to restore confidence in the mostly white police force. They're deploying body cameras and offering incentives to attract minority cadets.
Everyone's committed to making those changes, to talking about how we can move forward better, how we can be more inclusive, and how we can bring the entire city, you know, up out of this tragedy.
That means rebuilding the city's image as well as its infrastructure. Volunteers at the I Love Ferguson store have shipped merchandise to every state and about 36 countries.
It's like getting a big hug from everybody in the world.
All profits will go to grants to help local business owners rebuild. People like Juanita Morris.
This is all that's left for 28 years of business.
But with donations pouring in from around the country, she plans to rebuild.
I'm getting up. I'm not going to fall. I'm not going to stay down.
As for the people of Ferguson, they hope the changes will be more than mere window dressing. Alan Breed, Associated Press, Ferguson, Missouri.